The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Make us one, O God, in acknowledging Jesus the Christ. As we proclaim him by our words, let us follow him in our works. Give us strength to take up the cross and courage to lose our lives for his sake. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
to every one of you.
Amen.
And a warm welcome to our act of worship here today. A special welcome, as always, to our online congregation, worshiping with us via our Facebook page. Today is the 16th Sunday after Pentecost, and the collect and readings are for proper 19. I will offer you the sacrifice of thanksgiving and call upon the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open,
all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthy magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Spirit, may in all things direct and rule our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Please be seated for the ministry of the Word.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Proverbs, chapter 1, beginning at the 20th verse. Wisdom cries out in the street. In the squares, she raises her voice. At the busiest corner, she cries out. At the entrance of the city gates, she speaks. How long, O simple ones, will you love being simple? How long will scoffers delight in their scoffing and fools hate knowledge? Give heed to my reproof. I will pour out my thoughts to you. I will make my words known to you, because I have called and you refused, have stretched out my hand and no one heeded, and because you have ignored all my counsel and you have none of my reproof, I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when panic strikes you. Like a storm, and your calamity comes like a whirlwind, when distress and anguish come upon you. Then they will call upon me, but I will not answer. They will seek me diligently, but I have not found me, because they hated knowledge and did not choose to fear the Lord, would have none of my counsel and despised all my reproof. Therefore, they shall eat the fruit of their way and be sated with their own devices. For waywardness kills the scale, and the complacency of fools destroys them. But those who listen to me will be secure and will live at ease without dread of disaster. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the Word of God, written in the letter of James, chapter 3, beginning at the first verse. Not many of you should become teachers, my brothers and sisters, for you know that we who teach will be judged with greater strictness. For all of us make many mistakes. Anyone who makes no mistakes is speaking perfect, able to keep the whole body in check with a bridle. If we put bits into the mouth of horses to make them obey us, we guide their whole bodies. Or look at ships. Though they are so large that it takes strong winds to drive them, yet they are guided by a very small rudder, wherever the will of the pilot directs. So also the tongue is a small member, yet it boasts of great exploits. How great a forest is set ablaze by a small fire. And the tongue is a fire. The tongue is placed among our members as a world of iniquity. It stains the whole body, sets on fire the cycle of nature, and is itself set on fire by hell. For every species of beast and bird, of reptile and sea creature, can be tamed and has been tamed by the human species. But no one can tame the tongue, a restless evil full of deadly poison. With it, we bless the Lord and Father, and with it we curse those who are made in the likeness of God. From the same mouth come blessings and cursing. My brothers and sisters, this ought not to be so. Does a spring pour forth from the same opening both fresh and brackish water? Can a fig tree, my brothers and sisters, yield olives, or a grapevine figs? No more can salt yield fresh. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
from the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory to Christ, our Savior.
Jesus went on with his disciples to the villages of Caesarea Philippi. And on the way, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" And they answered him, "John the Baptist, and others Elijah, and still others one of the prophets." He asked them, "But who do you say that I am?" Peter answered him, "You are the Messiah." And he sternly ordered them not to tell anyone about him. Then he began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. He said all this quite openly, and Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." He called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. For what will it profit them to gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of them the Son of Man will also be ashamed when he comes in the glory of his Father with the angels."
This is the Gospel of Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray.
God our Father, you see your children growing up in an unsteady and a confusing world. Show them that your ways give more life than the ways of the world, and that following you is better than chasing after selfish goals. Help them to take failure on this journey, not as a measure of their worth, but as a chance for a new start. Give them strength to hold their faith in you, and to keep alive their joy in your creation, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May I speak to you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. As I read the epistle for today, I was quite glad that it was not used either last Sunday or the Sunday before that, when back to school was our focus. Could you imagine us focusing on and praying for teachers and students, and then hearing James say, "Not many of you should become teachers"? I think that would have been a bit awkward. But as awkward as that may have been, we do know that the words of James do ring true. And interestingly enough, the diocese is observing Education Sunday today. So more so than before, it is the right time to hear these words of James. Not many of you should become teachers, my brothers and sisters, for you know that we who teach will be judged with greater strictness. As we hear these words, let us think about James's time. Now, the teachers of his day would give public discourses to which students and other listeners would gather around. Can you imagine how easily someone listening can and seeking to learn from them could be led astray by intended or unintended words? I'm sure we can all imagine or even picture from our own personal experiences how negative words and behaviors can lead people astray. Mindful of how easy it is to lead others astray, let us turn now our focus to ourselves as Christians and our role in teaching and guiding others. Yes, I know that we are not perfect, but we have a responsibility to teach and lead those around us on the right path. No matter who we are, simply because we are Christians, we are in positions to teach and to influence others. We cannot take that lightly. Our lack of perfection is no excuse to back away from our responsibilities. Yes, from time to time, we will say and even do the wrong thing. But it is not acceptable for us to simply say, "I am human," and just brush it off as something that will happen. No. We must recognize that we need God's help on this journey, especially as we seek to teach others and to help them along. We most certainly need to learn to take a step back before we speak or act. In doing so, we can avoid many of the stumblings that we make when we are too hasty to act and speak, instead of pausing to seek God's help. My friends, as people who have a responsibility to help teach others and guide them along the Christian path, it is so necessary that we consider the importance of allowing God to guide us amidst our human weaknesses. Because so much that is wrong can happen if we do not. It is so important for us to recognize the importance of our words and the power of something as simple and as small as the tongue. James says that the tongue is a fire and compares it to a flame that lights a whole forest ablaze. In this age of technology, we need especially to be mindful of this. We need to consider how our words, whether spoken or typed, affect our lives and the lives of others. All of us as Christians must consider this and how it is influencing what is learnt by those observing us. Because the tongue and the text have the ability to lead astray and to destroy. So my brothers and sisters, if we profess our faith and our Christianity, if we are teaching those young in the faith, whether children or adults, then we cannot be on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, or WhatsApp saying, posting, or reposting negative things. We cannot be part of the spreading of slander and hate, division and strife, mischief and propaganda. If we do, we will be destroying our faith tradition for ourselves and in the eyes of those looking on. We will be teaching negatives and not the positive Christian way. As James said, we cannot bless God with the same tongue that we curse one another. A spring cannot pour out from the same opening, fresh and brackish water. Today, as Christians, as people with a responsibility to educate and nourish others, a people who James says will be judged with greater strictness, we need to consider what pours out of us, fresh or brackish water. What kinds of outputs do our mouths and our texts produce? What do these things really teach those around us? My friends, being a Christian, or more specifically, being someone who is called to share the Christian teachings they receive, is way more than singing, preaching, and the quoting of scripture. The way we live, the way we act, and the things we do in our day-to-day lives are all part of it. They are all part of what we teach, and therefore what people learn from us. The do as I say and not as I do model of teaching will never be an acceptable model of teaching for us. What we say with our lips, we need to believe in our hearts, and we need to practice in our daily lives. Without a doubt, there is great responsibility placed on us, because we are to help to shape the world in which we live in a positive way. And so I pray that we have been brave enough over the last few minutes to start doing some introspection. I hope that we have begun to recognize not only the high calling placed on us, but to recognize the areas where we may need to focus on improving. I pray that we commit ourselves to daily improvement as we seek to nurture and influence others, because there is so much at stake. Our communities are at stake. Our very religion is at stake as well, as our ability to pass it on to others. we as Christians do not take all of this seriously and allow God to guide us and allow God to be the guide that is so desperately needed in this and every age, then Christianity will decline and the evil in the world will increase. And although we would have died and gone, history would show that we influenced the negatives of the future because we did not try to live the best Christian lives we could in this, our present day, and pass on good teachings to those around us. So, what will we do? Will our tongues, our texts, our posts, our behaviors condemn us? Or will we put our trust in God and allow Him to guide what flows out from us as we seek to teach and nurture His people while daily praying the words of today's collect? O God, because without You we are not able to please You, mercifully grant that Your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Invite us now, with confidence, to reaffirm our faith as we say in the words of the Nicene Creed, we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen or unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, He was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, He rose again. In fulfillment of the Scriptures, He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, He is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please sit or kneel for our intercessory prayers.
Let us pray to the Father, who has called us to follow Christ in all things. Empower your church to follow Christ in all things, courageous to face the hard demands of the gospel. Keep your people from idle gossip and evil speaking, that the purity of their witness shall not be corrupted. Lord, in your mercy, fill with the love of truth those who influence the minds of others. Give to journalists and broadcasters the desire to make known the good as well as the bad, and to avoid anything that can mislead the innocent. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for all who are suffering from slander and false accusations, for those unjustly accused through malice or error. Give courage to those who are called to witness to their faith in peril and persecution. Lord, in your mercy, guard our speaking as we meet with others. Shield us in our families and in all our relationships from hasty words and disregard of truth. Lord, in your mercy, we pray that the souls of the departed who loved this world too much may be pardoned in the kingdom where true joys are to be found. May no evil report harm the memory of those who are at rest. Lord, in your mercy, as those who trust in Christ, the true Messiah, we pray in his name. Amen.
Thank you.
As we continue in this time of prayer, I invite the members of the altar guild staff. Brothers and sisters in Christ, let us uplift the members of our altar guild, especially remembering in our prayers this morning the newest member of the altar guild, Sister Helen, as well as Sister Yvette, who takes over the leadership. We give God thanks for the work of Sister Marlene, who has led the altar guild for the past few years. We thank God for the support and all the work of every member of the altar guild. Sister Karen, Sister Leslie, Sister Grace, all members past and present. The Levites are responsible for the ark, the table, the lampstand, the altars, and the vessels of the sanctuary, which the priests minister. The temple of the Lord, all are crying glory. Holiness adorns your house, O Lord, forever. Let us pray. O God, you accepted the service of the Levites in your temple, and your Son was pleased to accept the loving service of his friends. Bless the ministry of these persons and give them grace, that they, caring for the vessels and vestments of your worship and the adornment of your sanctuary, may make the place of your presence glorious. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May God bless you and your ministry. God of love and hope, you made the world and care for all creation. But the world feels strange now. The news is full of stories about COVID-19. Many are worried that they might get ill. Others are anxious for their family and friends. Be with them and help them to find peace. We pray for the doctors and nurses, the scientists, and all who are working to discover or refine the right medicines to help those who are ill. Thank you that even in these anxious times, O God, you are with us. Help us to put our trust in you and keep us safe. Amen. As a faith community, invite us to lift up each other at all times in prayer. And especially now, I invite us to lift up our brothers and sisters, who this time for them is one of mourning and sadness. As they continue to mourn the loss of persons who they love dearly, we especially remember in our prayers those who have lost loved ones who are not here, but are overseas. Let us honor them in our prayers and our support. Just remember, especially this morning, this is together. Brother Bruce, Sister Jackie, Brother Victor, Brother George, may we continue to pray for them, pray with them. Let us pray that God strengthens us to be his hands, his arms, his shoulders, our brothers and sisters to lean on as they journey through these challenging times. Before the departed, we pray, rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May their souls and the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercies of God, rest in peace. As I said at the 7 o'clock service, I had what I would say the rare privilege of celebrating my birthday at a funeral. A wonderful reminder of the gift of life and how we must cherish every moment that we are given. And so I invite us as we pray with and for our brothers and sisters in times of struggle. I invite us to do so, all this as well, in the joys of life. And if you are celebrating this morning, be it a birthday, a wedding anniversary, or any other anniversary, I invite you to come forward as we uplift you in prayer. Let us pray. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand, comfort them when they are discouraged or sorrowful. Raise them up if they fall, and in their hearts may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, abide with them all the days of their lives, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
The act of penitence. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us therefore confess our sins. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not loved ourselves as we ought. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your glory and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body, and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit. Let us then
pursue the things that make for peace,
and build
up a common life.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated for our notices.
Okay, good morning, brothers and sisters. Good to see you all this morning. Welcome, and welcome to those worshiping with us online as well. A special welcome to my sisters in the Altar Guild as we make our corporate communion. All right, if there's anyone who is visiting for the first time or is kind of new to us and wishes to be acknowledged, do let us know where you're from. Stand and let us know where you're from, if you so desire. Okay, all right, so just before I move into the remaining notices, just acknowledging the death of the Jamaican songbird, Karen Smith. She, a beautiful soul, and she was an avid and active supporter of St. George's when she was here. We pray that she is now resting in peace, and we ask God's comfort on her family. Rest eternal, grant unto Karen, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon her. May her soul and the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace. Heartiest congratulations to Kirk and Kendra Foster on the birth of their daughter, Kayla Lee Foster. Kayla is sister to Kobe Lem Foster and the granddaughter of Brother Lem and Sister Marcia Hurlston. I'm so glad I got that right. Kayla Lee was born on the 26th of August, and we just wish her and you every blessing. Congratulations to our brother John Paul Clark on his appointment as deputy chair of the board of Cayman Airways. We wish him every success. Congratulations to Chad Owens, who is here with us this morning, on his excellent achievements in the IGCSE. Congratulations. And congratulations to Debbie Pixley Clark on receiving the Badge of Honor for Meritorious Service, BHM, for contribution to the Jamaica Defense Force. And this took effect on August 6, Independence Day. Our midweek service continues this Wednesday at 10 a.m. And our food pantry still does need some items. Thank you to all who have donated so far. If you would like to have an idea of what's required, there's a list at the usher's desk. Do join us immediately after the service for breakfast in the garden in recognition of those persons celebrating birthdays in September. Okay, unless there are any other notices, it's only left for me to wish you a wonderful week, a productive week, and see you all next week, safe and sound.
Thank you.
dedication of the offering. Father, we offer you these gifts which you have given us,
this bread, this wine, this money.
With them we offer ourselves, our lives, and our work, to become, through your Holy Spirit, a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so may we and all your people become channels of your love, through the same Christ, O Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord. Father Almighty, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Into being. In your great love, you fashioned us in your image. In your tender compassion, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, to share our human nature. In the power of the Holy Spirit, he overcame the power of sin and death and brought your people to new birth as first fruits of your new creation. On the night that he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to the command of your dearly beloved Son,
amen.
thanks and praise. Send your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, Jesus, our Lord and Redeemer. As we partake of this holy food of new and unending life, may your Holy Spirit establish us as a royal priesthood, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. George, and all your sons and daughters who share in your eternal inheritance through Jesus Christ, our Lord. With him, and in him, and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise. Gifts of God for the people of God.
Our souls in peace can be satisfied, and we will sing blessed songs of praise to Him.
Thank you.
for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you and all persons in you with gladness and singleness of heart, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you this day and forevermore.
Jesus, I